Welcome to the DLP Lab session covering how to get started with the world's smallest 1080p EVM. My name is Juan Alvarez. I am going to walk you through this training. In just a few steps, you can be up and running with this EVM. First, we will cover some basic information about the 0.23 1080p chipset and the EVM itself. Then, we will share with you what you should expect to get when you open up the EVM and what else you may need to get the EVM working. Finally, we have a few steps on what you need to do to get started, either to evaluate the image quality of the EVM or if you want to start your own application using the EVM. So let's get started by discovering a bit more about the 0.23 1080p chipset and EVM. The 0.23 1080p chipset is the most affordable way to enable a 1080p display with DLP technology. It uses a 5.4 micron pixel, but with four-way actuation, it can achieve an effective 2.7 micron pixel with the image quality properties of a 5.4 micron pixel. It offers extremely low power with its optical architecture, which requires no polarization. It also features IntelliBright algorithms that enable up to 50% more brightness with no increase in power. The chipset enables excellent image quality with saturated colors, high contrast ratio, and is based on the same architecture as DLP cinema technology, used in over 9 out of 10 digital movie theaters worldwide. Now, a bit later, we learn more about its chipset, which includes a display controller, a PMIC, and a DMD, which is short for Digital Micromirror Device. The EVM is world's smallest Pico 1080p EVM with 100 lumens out of the box. Although the chipset itself can support up to 350 lumens depending on the optical engine architecture. Now, let's cover more details about the EVM. At the core of our DLP Pico products, all chipsets enable low power, freeform, on-demand displays. This means that you can make any surface a display when it's needed. The EVM supports a wide variety of low-cost processors. Having said that, its pinout is optimized to work with the Raspberry Pi out of the box. The EVM is developer-friendly, and we will cover this in more detail later on. And last but not least, the EVM is offered at a very affordable price of $299 on TIA.com. With all this in mind, the chipset can enable a wide variety of display applications. Many display applications include small appliance applications, including countertops, refrigerators, washing machines, and air conditioning systems, interactive surface displays at restaurants or point of sales, and many more, ultra-compact projection displays, and augmented reality glasses. The possibilities are virtually endless. Now that we have a general idea of the chipset and the EVM, let's dig a bit deeper to understand the chipset system and PCB layout of the EVM itself. Given this is a display EVM, you will need video input and power. For this reason, the EVM includes an 18-bit RGB parallel video interface to send video content and I2C interface to make changes to the configuration of the display. You will also need a 5-volt power supply with more than 3 amps. The video input goes to an FPGA to process the video data coming in. The FPGA then sends a parallel video interface to the DLPC3436 display controller. At the same time, the display controller works with the DLPA2005 PMIC to provide power to the LEDs and the 0.23 1080p DMD. At a high level, what we have just reviewed is all the electronic portion of the display subsystem. Notice the placement of all the connectors for the cabling of the EVM. Fan cable to the middle left, power lower left, DMD, flex cable, and LED cables to the right. Now, let's transition to the optical engine where the fan, LED, and DMD flex cables are going to be connected. Here is the view of the optical engine without the electronics board. Here are the locations of all the cables located on the optical engine for the fan, DMD flex cable, and LEDs. Also, notice locations of the 0.23 1080p DMD and the flex cable used for the actuator. Now that we have a clear idea of the entire display subsystem, let's learn how this product fits in the overall DLP Pico product portfolio. The DLP Pico product portfolio has an extensive product lineup, ranging from NHD to 4K resolution and supporting up to 1500 lumens. The 0.23 1080p supports up to 350 lumens. The 0.23 1080p chipset has the same diagonal as the QHD and HD chipsets. With that in mind, all of these three DMDs could leverage the same optical engine with different actuator configurations. The 0.23 QHD chipset does not use an actuator. The 0.23 HD chipset uses a two-way actuator, and the 0.23 1080p uses a four-way actuator. This approach allows you to have a good, better, best position for your next generation display application. As a more affordable and lower resolution option, you could also use our 0.2 NHD chipset. This chipset offers the most affordable way to evaluate DLP technology with a $99 EVM. Similar to the 0.23 1080p EVM, the 0.2 NHD EVM can be used with a low-cost processor. Its pinout is optimized for the BeagleBone Black, but there is already documentation on the E2E forum on how to use it with the Raspberry Pi. Now that you have a high-level understanding of the 0.23 1080p chipset and its EVM, let's take a look at what you would get when you unbox the EVM itself. In the box, you will find the EVM and a Raspberry Pi cable. There are a few items that are not included in the EVM. First off, you will need a 5-volt DC power supply that can support a minimum of 3 amps. Although the EVM can be used with an FPD link connection, the FPD link header is not included. You would need to solder this connector on the EVM if you need the interface. Also, the Raspberry Pi and its SD card is not included either. For reference, we include the part numbers of the EVM and its chipsets on the upper right corner if you need to learn more about each component. So now you have opened up the EVM and you are ready to start evaluating and developing with the world's smallest 1080p EVM. There are two use cases that this EVM supports. The first one is a standalone mode. With this use case, you should be able to quickly assess the excellent image quality that DLP technology has to offer. The other use case is designed to allow you to start your development right away with the Raspberry Pi or any other low-cost processor. So, let's take a look at the first use case. The first thing you want to do is connect the power to the EVM. Then, you just need to wait a few seconds. You will see the DLP logo briefly, and then you will see a color bar screen where you can look at the full HD definition of the display, as well as the image quality. That's it. When you're done, Just unplug power and you are pretty much done. Now, let's take a look at the second use case. For this use case, you will need to download a few files to get started. You will want to download and install the latest RPi OS. You will also want to download the system config file from TI.com located in the DLP230NP EVM tool folder. After you're done with that download, you will want to install the system configuration file with your Raspberry Pi. Then, download the Python software package from TI.com and load the software package to your Raspberry Pi. You should be ready to power up the system. Ensure that both EVM and Raspberry Pi do not have power. Now, go ahead and connect the Raspberry Pi to the EVM using the cable that came with your EVM. After you have verified that the EVM and the Raspberry Pi are well connected, you will want to power both systems. First, power the 0.23 1080p EVM. Wait until you see the color bars, then power the Raspberry Pi using a USB Type-C cable and power supply. So now you should be able to start developing with the EVM. Keep in mind that our system allows for free-form on-demand display. Make sure you come up with the most creative visual experience you can think of. There is a lot of information available on TI.com if you want to learn more or if you have any issues, and we have linked that information below the video. You can download the user's guide from the DLP230NP tool folder. You can go to ti.com/DLP where you can find the Getting Started section for DLP Pico display technology. You can also search DLP Labs on the web where you will find a video that discusses how to select the chipset that is best suited for your application. We have all that information linked to that video below. In the DLP Lab series, you can also find a video that covers brightness requirements. This is really good to understand how bright you need your DLP Pico display optical engine needs to be for your application. As an alternative, you can also click on the links of this DLP Labs video in the description area. If you have any questions, visit our E2E community and talk to our product experts. And if you want to learn more about the 0.23 1080p chipset, you can also check out the technical article called Designing Smaller Mobile Projection and Display Applications with DLP Pico Products. We have provided a link below for your convenience. That's it. By now, you should have a very good overview of the 0.23 1080p chipset and EVM, as well as learning what you get with the EVM and how to get started with evaluating DLP Pico display technology and developing with it. Good luck with your new display application development. Thanks for watching. As a reminder, check out the links on this page to learn more about the world's smallest 1080p EVM.